Hola, bienvenidos a All Spanish. Welcome to All Spanish. Soy Brenda, tu profesora de español. If you're new to our channel, welcome, bienvenidos. Consider subscribing if you would like to check our weekly Spanish lessons. Today, we're going to have a look at 10 different expressions with the verb tener, to have. The verb tener en español significa, it means to have. But these 10 expressions that I'm going to be sharing with you today, when we translate these expressions, we use different verbs in English. So that's why it's important to learn these particular expressions and remember how to use them with this specific verb, tener, and not try to translate or make sense out of it in our head. We just simply need to learn what they mean and how to use them. Because if we translate them literally, they basically don't make a lot of sense. And if you try to convey these expressions using the verb that we would use in English, it just simply doesn't work. How is this gonna work? We're gonna talk about the expression, then I'm gonna give you an example, and also I'm going to give you, the example will probably be with the first person, yo, and then we're also gonna have a look at the question for you, so that you get to start practicing how you would put this into a conversation. Número uno. The first one is related to age. When we want to talk about how old we are, in Spanish, we're gonna use it with the verb tener, to have, and as you know, in English, we'll use the verb to be instead. So in Spanish, we basically possess years. We say, I have this many years, instead of saying, I am this many years old. Pregunta, ¿cuántos años tienes? How old are you? You can see we're using the verb tener in here. ¿Cuántos años tienes? Por ejemplo, yo tengo 34 años. ¿Cuántos años tienes? Número 2. Tener hambre. Tener hambre significa to be hungry. So remember here, as you can see, we're using a different verb in Spanish. Tener hambre. Tener hambre. Pregunta. ¿Tienes hambre? Are you hungry? ¿Tienes hambre? Respuesta, tengo hambre. So if someone is coming to your house, you can ask this question, ¿tienes hambre? Are you hungry? And then offer some food to your beautiful guests. Número 3, tener sed. Tener sed. Tener sed significa to be thirsty. Yeah? So you're thirsty. As you can see, we're using with the verb tener and not to be in Spanish. Por ejemplo, tengo sed. I am thirsty. Tengo sed. Pregunta, ¿tienes sed? ¿Tienes sed? Again, if someone is coming to your house, you can ask, ¿tienes sed? ¿Tienes hambre? And then be a great host. Now, if you're going to a Latino's house instead, and they ask you these questions, ¿tienes hambre? ¿Tienes sed? And you actually want to reject food, I made a specific video lesson on how to reject three different ways on how to reject food in Spanish. It's very important. Check it out. It's a more of a cultural tip. Número 4. Tengo sueño. Tener sueño significa to be sleepy. Ejemplo, tengo sueño. Pregunta, ¿tienes sueño? Now be careful. A lot of my students usually put the sueños in the plural and say tengo sueños, but that would be incorrect. That means I have dreams. So if you want to say that you are sleepy, you have to say tengo sueño, just in a singular form. Número 5, tener prisa. Tener prisa. Tener prisa significa to be in a hurry. Por ejemplo, tengo prisa. Tengo prisa. ¿Tienes prisa? That would be the question. ¿Tienes prisa? You can use this expression when you're running late and you bump into someone, you need to tell them that you're in a hurry, you can say, tengo prisa, lo siento. Número 6. Tener calor. Tener calor significa to be hot. But in this case, we use it to talk about the weather. When it's hot, then you have to use this expression, tener calor. Tengo calor. Por ejemplo, tengo calor. I am hot, or it's hot. Número 7. Tener frío. frío es el opuesto de tener calor. So, tener frío is the opposite of tener calor. Instead of being hot, it's actually cold. Por ejemplo, tengo frío, I am cold. And la pregunta, ¿tienes frío? Are you cold? Would be the question. Imagine how great of a host you will be so far. You have asked your guests if they are hungry, if they are thirsty, if they are cold, or if they are hot, just to adjust the temperature. Oh my goodness, you're such a good host. Tener miedo a. Tener miedo a is an expression that we use to express fear or to talk about what you are scared of. Tengo miedo a. And it's important to note that you have this preposition here, a. Tener miedo a algo, to be afraid of something. Por ejemplo, tengo miedo a las arañas. Tengo miedo a las alturas. Tengo miedo a los tiburones. Tengo miedo a manejar o conducir. So you can also use it with verbs like tengo miedo a manejar o conducir, tengo miedo a nadar. ¿Y tú? ¿A qué tienes miedo? ¿A qué tienes miedo? What are you afraid of? Let me know in the comments. Tener ganas de. Tener ganas de significa to feel like doing something, to feel like. Ganas is that feel, that willingness, ganas. Tener ganas de, so remember the preposition here will be de. And we can say tener ganas de algo o tener ganas de hacer algo. So in the first one we're just gonna use a noun, in the second one we're gonna need a verb. You can only use it here, you don't need the verb in the ing form like in English, we only need the verb in the infinitive form. Let's have a look at some examples. Tengo ganas de comer chocolate. Tengo ganas de ir al cine. Tengo ganas de ir a la playa. Tengo ganas de comer pizza. La última, the last one, tener dolor de. Tener dolor de significa to be sore or to hurt in the body, in different parts of the body. Por ejemplo, tengo dolor de cabeza. Tengo dolor de estómago. Tengo dolor de dientes o muelas, etc. Something important to point out is that if we want to negate all these expressions, it's very simple. All you have to do is put a no before the verb and to basically negate it and say the opposite. So, for example, tengo hambre, no tengo hambre. I am hungry, I am not hungry. Tengo calor, no tengo calor. Okay, it's hot or no, it's not hot for me. Tengo miedo a las arañas. No tengo miedo a las arañas. As you can see here, we are saying what we are afraid of or what we are not afraid of. Muy bien, estudiantes, that's all for today. I really hope that you enjoyed these 10 expressions with the verb tener en español. And remember that the verb tener in Spanish means to have, but we use it with all these expressions that probably we use a different verb in English. In the comments down below, let me know which is your favorite expression with the verb tener that we have learned today, and maybe put it in a sentence just to practice. If you like this video, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. We'd love to have you as a subscriber and one of our students on YouTube. And remember to hit that bell so that you don't miss our notifications when we upload a new video lesson on Tuesdays. Teaching Spanish is our passion and we would love to have you as our student. So if you want to check out our courses, I'll leave you the link of our website in the description box. Muy bien, eso es todo por hoy, that's all for today. Muchas gracias, thank you so much for watching and I will see you next class. Adiós!